What you actually see here is a graph of a generic function. It doesn't really matter which is the mathematical expression that corresponds to this graph. And this slider on the top is changing the value of a constant that is added or subtracted, if you want, outside the function. I would like you to notice one thing. This function has a peak, and then it's afterwards is oscillating in a damped way around this axis, the axis of corresponding to the vertical coordinates equal to zero. So let's see what happens if I add a positive number, like 0.1 or 0.2 or 0.4, etc. You actually see the function is rigidly shifting up. And the way I am explaining this to me is by looking at the previous axis where this function was oscillating. You actually see it is still here, but it's not anymore coinciding to this vertical coordinates equal to zero. It has been actually shifted rigidly up. And the same occurs if I start bringing negative a negative constant added to this function, like -2, -3, -0.3. And you actually see that it's like rigidly shifting this function down. And this rigid translation occurs vertically, towards the top when the numbers are positive, or towards the bottom when the numbers are negative. Adding a constant, if you want, outside, therefore, is pretty simple and straightforward. I will demonstrate to you what happens when you add the constant inside. Once more, you correctly guess there is going to be a translation. This time, the translation is going to be up or down, but it's going to be left or right. So let's assume that I start with a negative value, like -1, -2, -3. You actually see that the function is shifting towards the right. Vice versa, if I use positive constant added inside the function, like 3 or 4 or 5 or 6, you actually see that the function is translating towards the left. Indeed, I found it a little bit counterintuitive, because before, positive quantities were going in the direction of positive vertical coordinates, whereas in this case, it's actually vice versa. Positive constant added inside moves towards the direction of negative values of the horizontal coordinate. The way I explain it to myself is in a slightly different way. You actually see the peak here. The peak before was located to the corresponding horizontal coordinate that were equal to zero. It is in these terms that you should see this. The argument x plus 6 in this case will repeat what was the corresponding independent variable value that was before for x equal to 0 when x plus 6 is equal to 0. So x in this case needs to be minus 6, and you actually see it's actually here, down here. That is roughly explaining and clarifying to me why it moves left and not right for positive values. Let me now show you what happens if you multiply the function by a factor. In this case, it's a factor, and the factor is 1. It doesn't change, obviously, the graph of the function. Let's see what happens if it's larger than 1, if it's 1.6. You will actually see that when it's 1.6, the function is being stretched vertically. In another way, you can think equivalently to a way to zoom in vertically or to change the numbers on the vertical axis. In all cases, you actually see that there is a stretch or zoom in only in one direction. This happens because the multiplicative factor is outside. I didn't show you, however, what happens when the multiplicative factor is lower than 1, but you probably can understand what happens to a function when it is going to be shrinked 70% of its amplitude everywhere, like in this case. Something a little bit interesting or more interesting is when this factor is negative, you will see and witness to a flip. So to a kind of symmetry, you actually see it's going down and then it's going to point to minus 0.1 and then it's increasing, minus 0.6. And you actually see that the peak of this function is pointing downwards instead of upwards. Well, that's clear. All the numbers of these functions have been changed of sign. Those that were positive became negative and vice versa. Finally, let me show you what happens when the multiplicative factor is inside. You might have guessed correctly that when this is performed, when this operation is performed, you're going to assist to a kind of stretching, but this time is occurring along the horizontal direction. Once more, let me try by increasing, by multiplying by a factor 1.7 inside. You actually see that it's getting more concentrated, more squeezed with respect to what was before. And in a way, it's as if you are renumbering the values of the horizontal axis, or you're zooming out. This is the case for a number larger than 1. If the number is smaller than 1, you actually see that there is a progressive slowing down, if you want, of these oscillations, or stretching out of these oscillations. When the number is negative, you might have guessed and spot that I did not really choose the best possible example. Indeed, the graph of this function is symmetric with respect to the vertical axis. So yes, by multiplying inside by a negative number, you see a flip, and this flip is symmetrical with respect to the vertical axis. Now, the function is already symmetric, so you don't actually notice it. I invite you to take any other function that you can think of and try to explore by yourself what happens when you put a minus inside the argument of the function. Let me summarize what we see. When you add a constant, being 0.3 or 0.5, the graph of a function moves upwards, as if you're moving the entire axis, the horizontal axis, up or down in case of a negative a negative quantity added. If you instead consider adding a constant inside, you actually are going to have once more a rigid shift, but this time it's going to be along the horizontal direction, towards the left if the argument is positive, towards the right if the argument is negative. And I invited you to think about this concept of matching what was the original graph that had a peak for the argument that was zero, and trying to replicate the same concept. Well, this function will have a peak when the argument is going to be zero. So in this case, when the argument x is going to be equals to 8. Or in this case, when the argument x is going to be equals minus 8. Multiplying by a constant corresponds to a kind of stretching, vertical or horizontal. If the multiplication factor is outside, you actually have a compression, reduction of the amplitudes everywhere, a scaling, or an upscaling if the factor is larger than 1. And if the factor is negative, you have something that is a flipped version, scaled and flipped version of the original function. Finally, if the multiplying factor is inside, if lower than 1 or larger than 1, you have a stretching, and once more the stretching is along the horizontal, not vertical, direction in this case. But for negative numbers, the flip that you would expect, horizontal flip across the around the axis, the vertical axis of symmetry, in this specific case of the function that I showed, was not apparent because the function itself was already symmetric.